I'm Mark Winchester with Winchester Metalworks, and today we're going to do some chromoly tube. So on chromoly, it's a good idea to clean up the mill scale a little bit, just so you're not trying to burn through it. The way that I clean the tube is I just use a red Scotch-Brite pad to remove the mill scale. And then if it's oily or has any sort of cutting fluid of sort, I'll use a little bit of acetone just to clean off the oil to help the weld be a little cleaner. So today we're going to be running the Lightning MTS-275. We're going to have 0.2 seconds of pre-flow just to get a little bit of gas ahead of the arc. And then 10 seconds of post-flow so we have gas coverage post-weld. And we're going to run about 80 amps on the foot pedal. So the tungsten that I use on chromoly is the Weldporn Multi-Mix 332 diameter. The filler metal we're using is 045 ER70S2. So the cup that I normally use welding chromoly in my shop is the Furic 12 cup. I run it around 25 CFH. I get really good gas coverage on chromoly using that cup. So a good rule of thumb for setting amperage on chromoly is to follow the 1 amp per thousand thickness rule. So we're welding an 83/1000 thick chromoly, and we're gonna be welding it at around 80 amps. Keeping your arc length tight is key. Pulling your arc length away, you're gonna make the puddle hotter, so it's gonna be harder to control the heat. Keeping a tight arc length, watching your step over, you want more like a 75% overlap in bead spacing, and this also helps control the heat as well, because you're introducing cold filler into the weld puddle, so it's cooling the weld, it's helping control the heat, and it also helps tie in the toes of the weld, so it's not a definitive line in between bead spacing, so you don't create stress risers. What you're looking for is proper fill. It's really easy to underfill on chromoly and you get undercut. So filling the proper amount so you don't get undercut is important. When you feel like you're not stepping over enough, is basically when you're stepping over the right amount. Because a lot of people, they'll step over too far. The tighter the bead spacing, see how like all the toes of the weld are like almost in a line? Like it's like a perfect line, you barely see the toes of the weld. Like your step over is extremely minimal to get that profile. Like if you step over too far, like you'll actually see a definitive like toe in the weld. So keeping the bead spacing tight, you're able to keep a continuous line on the toes. So on this weld, we had proper bead spacing and proper fill. The toe line is wet in, no undercut. You don't have any gray areas. You got lots of good color. It shows that you're not overheating the weld joint. When you're stepping over too far, you create a hard toe line, which could create undercut and stress risers. So here's an example of too far of step over. So you can see in between each bead spacing, there's like a hard line in between the bead spaces. This can create a stress riser. So let me show you an example of stepping too far. So here we have the same settings, and I'm showing you an example of what happens if you step over too far. You get a hard line in between your toes. So keeping your step overs to a minimum will ensure that your toes are tied in together so you don't have a stress riser in between bead spacing. So hood time and educating yourself will only make it better. So we're gonna wrap up this episode. I'm Mark Winchester at Winchester Metalworks. Weld mean, weld green.